Hi, and in today's video I'm going to show you where you can find some free images and pictures for your documents and projects, how to insert them and also how to move them. So if we go up to the Insert tab here and we go along to Pictures, click on the drop down and you'll see that we've got an option for stock images. Now if we click on that, Word has got a huge number of images that you can use for your projects and your documents. And the great thing is it's got a search engine at the top here. So if I was to type in, for example, yellow flowers, you can see I have a huge amount of options to choose. Likewise, if I type in something like people, again, you can see I have a number of different options. Now from this menu, if I wanted to insert something, let's say this image here, you just click on the circle. And then if you want to click on more, you just keep clicking on the different circles and then you just click insert. If you're using the images from Word, I'll show you how you can move them around, but I will go on to show you some free images online and how you can insert those as well. So first of all, once you've inserted your image, you'll see that if you try to move this, it won't move. It just keeps clicking back into its original position. So what we need to do is to change the wrapping. So select it, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down, and you can select from any of these here. I generally choose In Front of Text. Once you've done that, you can move it anywhere you like in your document. Obviously, you can also resize it by grabbing one of the squares in the corner. So if we go onto the internet and we go to this website here called pixabay.com, again, a similar option, you're given huge amounts of images you can choose from. But again, at the top here, you have a search bar option. So we can type in beach. And again, you can see what comes up. Now, the great thing about this particular option is it's got this drop down here. So if you click on the drop down in the search bar, you can see you have multiple selections. So it's not just images, it's videos, music, sound effects, etc. But you can choose some photos, vector graphics, or illustrations. So let's click on illustrations. So as you can see, none of these are photographs, they're all digitally made. And if you want to go onto vectors, again, you're going to get something more along the lines of cartoons and illustrations. So in the same theme, let's just type in dog. Let's go to another photograph. If we click on this photograph here, it'll take you to this page where you can click on free download. You can select the size of the image that you want to download and just simply click download. Now, once you're back in Word, just go to insert, pictures, click on the drop down, and this time we're going to select picture from file. So here in my downloads, I just select the file I want and click insert. Again, this file won't move, so select it, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down, and select In Front of Text. And once again, you can move this anywhere and also resize it. Now, if you want your images to be the same size, select it, go to Picture Format, go along to this section here, and you can choose whether you want them to be in the same height or the same width. You can have them as both, but you will need to crop the images. So let's, for the moment, choose the same width. So let's say we want them both at 10, plus 10 in there, go to the top image, back over here, select 10 and press enter. And there you have exactly the same width. To make sure they're lined up, if they're slightly offset, select them both by selecting the bottom one, holding down your command or control key, select the top one. You can go to align, click on the drop down and simply align to left, or you can align to middle, or you can align to right. It's completely up to you. If you want these images to be in the center of your page, you can do that one at a time if you want to by selecting the image individually, going to align, align to center, or you can select them both, go to group, click on the drop down and select group. Then align, align to center, and then they're perfectly line up to the center of your page. So for this project, I'm going to put in some more images. So I'm just going to select these two images or select the group, go to group and select ungroup. I'm going to move them both over to the left here, and then I'm actually going to make them a little bit smaller. You can actually resize them both at the same time. If you've selected them both, holding down that command or control key, you can actually grab this bottom square here and you can resize them at the same time, which is really useful. So I'm going to go and grab some more images. If you do decide to insert multiple images at the same time, generally this is what happens. But again, don't panic, we've just got to use the wrapping tool and it will all condense down to one page. Okay, so now my pictures are all the same width. I'm just going to move them all down. Now, if you find one doesn't move, it's because you've missed the wrapping on it. Okay, so I just want all of mine to be roughly in the middle of the page. So I'm going to select this row here and I'm going to go to Align. Distribute vertically to make sure they're equally spaced out, and then align to left, and then they're all lined up along this left edge here. Same with this side. I'm going to move that one down to align to this one here. So I'm going to select both of those, make sure they're lined up to the top, so align to top, perfect. And then I'm going to select this entire row and again distribute vertically, and I'm going to do align to right, so they're all lined up along this line here. Now you can see these two at the bottom aren't similar size. If that doesn't matter, that's not the point here. My point was to get them all the same width. There's a big gap in the middle here, so I'm going to group all of these together, select them all, go to group, select group, and here as well, just holding down that command or control key to select multiple photos. And then I'm going to move these in like this, about that far apart, perfect. I'm going to select them both the groups, select group, and group them all together. So that's all one group now. I simply go to align, align to center, align to middle. And now they're all perfectly lined up into the center of your page. So that's just an overview of where you can find some free images for your documents, how you can insert them, align them, and also resize them. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.